We are the creators of our destiny. We have made our lives pitiful by becoming puppets at the hands of our own weaknesses and shortcomings. We can overcome these with the help of our own conscience and perceptions. But for this, we need to go through a mental transformation. This mental transformation is the foundation of a new era. Pandit Shri Ram Sharma Acharya. Book name, Har Subah Naya Janm, Har Raat Nayi Maut. A new birth every morning and a new death every night. Book introduction. Our religion has advised Sandhya, the twilight time, Vandan, that is prayers, twice a day, just before sunrise and about sunset. It is the time when the sun and stars are visible in the sky together. The practice of Sandhya Vandan is mentioned even in Ramayana and Mahabharata, periods in Indian history. Vedic saints believe that these times of the day, when the body and mind are fully active, we can leverage these periods to strengthen the mind. The intellect is the most important means of self-evolution of the soul. Intellect is the faculty capable of discriminating that reveals the ephemeral nature of things around us and ultimately helps realize the soul's eternal nature. The one whose intellect has been carried away by violent sense organs quickly perishes. Therefore, purification and enlightenment of the intellect are the prime means for self-protection. Sandhya Vandan, that is twilight prayers, purify the body and mind and enlightens the intellect. We complain that we are too busy to do Sandhya Vandan at the depicted time. So Pandit Shri Ram Sharma Acharya, the writer of today's book, found an easy and doable Sandhya Vandan without much ado. This book describes how we can do a very practical form of Sandhya Vandan immediately on waking up, that is Atmabodh in the morning, and just before we go to bed, Tattva Bodh Sadhana at night. In the morning, we should make a plan for how to utilize the day best, and in the evening, we need to ponder over the successes and failures of the day. Based on both success and lessons learned from the day's failure, we should plan the next day. And at night time when we sleep, we should presume that we are leaving this world. This helps in detachment with people and things. This book will open you to one of the simplest yet most effective path of self-transformation, encapsulation, the nectar of Indian philosophy. Few excerpts from the book. First, God, do not expect puja, offerings, bhajans, prasad, clothes or kirtans from us. He is not bothered by these things. These are for our own purification and rectification only. People believe that God is pleased with their puja and prasad, but it is not so. God only wants one thing, and that is how we utilize the precious life given to us by Him. God has given us an extraordinary gift to us from His treasury, this life. Second, every day when you get up in the morning, think about how you will utilize this day. Every day is a new birth, and every night is a new death. Think as if today is the last day of your life, so make a timetable regarding what and how and when you will do these things. Add intention to each activity. Anything done with purpose and deliberation will make it worthwhile. Third, make your daily timetable so that there is time to earn your livelihood and time for your family. But at the same time, make time for activities that satisfy and uplift your soul and also activities that please God. Swadhyaya, that is self-study knowledge, seva, selfless services, and upasana, that is worship, should also be included in daily routine. If all of this is included in making your daily timetable morning, Sandhya Vandan is complete. Fourth, early morning you can decide what you will do that day. In the same way, you should contemplate your mistakes and success during the day just before you go to sleep. If you do so, you will be more successful the next day. So every day at bedtime, think that you are on your deathbed and are going to meet God soon. So what should you do? You have to reduce your attachment to people and things. Attachment is difficult and binding, while responsibilities are not. Be responsible towards your mother, wife, children, neighbors, and society, but do so in a detached manner. How? Don't say my son, say God's son. Don't say my wife, say God's daughter. When you go to sleep at night, think about death. Realize that you came empty-handed and will go empty-handed. Your money, your possessions are not coming with you. Everyone comes with their sanskars, that is attributes, and will go with their sanskars. Few topics covered in the book. न्यू बर्थ एवरी मॉर्निंग एंड न्यू डेथ एवरी नाइट. ट्राई टू बी ह्यूमन. वेज टू इम्प्रूव योर लाइफ. थिंक अबाउट योर डेथ एंड बर्थ. लर्न फ्रॉम योर मिस्टेक्स, दैट इज सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन एंड आत्मबोध एंड तत्वबोध.